Hello everyone and welcome back to another tutorial. In this video, I'll show you guys how you can add custom color swatches to your product page without any app. And I have created multiple tutorials for color swatches on Shopify product page, but this one is the far most featureful. And after using this one, you won't be needing any Shopify app, that I guarantee, because it has multicolor swatches, dual color swatch, tri-color swatch. You can display variant image just by click of a button without using any Shopify app. Yes, you heard it right. All you have to do is just follow this video along, copy and paste few code snippets, which I'm going to provide you guys in the video description, and you will be done with this. So first, let me show you how it's going to look like after you implement this tutorial. So as you can see that on my screen, I have the product page and I have color swatching showing up. You can see I have dual color swatch and I have a tri-color swatch, right? And all you have to do is just add the hex code for your colors here. So this one is for tri-color swatch, and this value is for dual color swatch. And you can also display custom image to any of the swatch. So for example, if I want to display custom variant image to green color swatch, I can simply add the file name and it will show the image here. So I already have a file on my Shopify files by the name of logo.png. And if I add that file name here, you can see that it's showing the logo and replaced it with the color. Cool, right? Now I'm going to add back the green color. And here's my green color is back. Now, if I click on variant image, it will switch itself and pull all of the variant images which are on your product backend. So in order to make this option work, make sure you have the variant images selecting on the product page. I'm going to walk you through shortly of how you can do that. You will need to define all of the colors. You don't need to add any app for that. You don't need to create any meta fields or upload any images. All you have to do is just add the hexa code of your color and it will automatically convert it to color swatch. Now there are some additional features of this style. So if you don't like the round color swatch, you can make it square like this. And if you want rounded corners, you can also do that by selecting square rounded corners. And we also have a fourth option, which will only work when you have selected variant image. So let me show you how it's going to look. I'm going to switch to portrait mode. And here you go. Cool, right? You can also increase the swatch size. So we have this size increaser. So if I switch to 60 pixel, you can see that the size is increasing. You don't have to code it in CSS. You don't have to add any code in any CSS file. You can do all of the changes via customize and theme settings. So all you have to do is just navigate to product template. So that's our product template, and you will see an option on theme settings. And here you will have this option, color swatches by WebSense Pro. And now let's start implementing that. Before doing so, make sure to click this button and subscribe our channel. It will help you get the latest updates from our channel. We keep creating this type of tutorial for you guys without any cost. You can get all of the instructions for free. Link in the description below. Follow the tutorial and you'll be able to implement that using this video as well. So here's the tutorial which we'll be following. Again, you will find the link in the video description. Okay, now let's start implementing that. Currently, I have Sense theme published. Now what I'm going to do, I'll publish a new theme in order to show you guys that how it works. Okay. Let's exit this. And that's my development store. And I have Sense theme published. What I'm going to do, I'll add a new theme. You can implement this tutorial on any of the free theme, no matter you have Dawn, Spotlight, Refresh, Craft, Sense, or any of the free theme. You can use this very easily. It's not going to work on any of the paid theme. And if you want help implementing this to your paid theme, let us know by clicking on the link in the video description, you will find a link which will take you to the contact us page, and you can simply write us, you can simply submit a form and contact us, and we'll be able to help you with the customization. Okay, now I'm going to add the spotlight theme. While this theme is installing, I want to give an announcement that if you are setting up your Shopify store newly and you want a promotion and you want your store to start for just $1 per month, you can do so by clicking on the link below. We have an affiliate link on the video description. So when you sign up to your Shopify store using that link, you will get your Shopify subscription down to $1 per month for starting 3 months. So if you want to avail this offer, make sure to sign up using the link in the YouTube video description and avail this opportunity. Okay, my spotlight theme has been installed. Now I'm going to publish that. Click on publish and then publish again. Okay, now we will add our swatches feature on our newly installed spotlight theme. Let's preview the theme first of how our product page looks like. So here's the t-shirt product, and you can see we have colors showing up in our drop-down menu. So the first step is to make sure that you select fill option type in your color swatch by going to customize settings. Let me show you how. So let's go to themes, click on customize, click on this drop-down here, click on product, and then select default product. And here, click on variant picker under product information, and from there make sure you select it as pills and not the drop down, because in case of drop down our tutorial is not going to function properly. Okay, I'm going to hit save and start adding some codes to this theme so our color swatches can work. Okay guys, now let's go to the code editor. In order to go to the code editor, we'll click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have a backup of your theme. Just create a duplicate of your live theme in case you're working on a live shop. Cool. And that's the tutorial which we'll be following. The first step is to add the following code in settings_schema.json. So that's the code. We'll navigate to settings_schema.json. And we will add this code on the top of the file after this bracket. I'm going to add a line break, click on copy code button and paste it here. After pasting the code, hit save. And now let's move on to the next step. Now for that, we will need to replace some code in product-variant-picker.liquid file. That's the code which we will be replacing with the following code. Okay. Now let's search for this file. Okay, now we will search the code which we are looking to replace. So that's the code we are replacing with the following code. Cool. Now let's search it. I'm going to copy the class from the piece of this field set and search it in my product-variant-picker.liquid file. And that's the code. That's the field set. Now I'm going to replace it with the code which I have here. So just click on copy code and paste it here and hit save again. Okay. Let's move on to the tutorial again. And that's a final step, where we will be adding a new snippet called color-option.liquid. Okay. Click on add a new snippet from your code editor here. Make sure to have this same file name, which is color-option.liquid, and then paste the code available here. So I'm going to copy the code, create file called color-option. And paste the code. Perfect. After pasting the code, hit save. And we are done with our tutorial. Now all we have to do is just preview the theme and make sure that it's working fine. I'm going to click on preview store. And then go to the product where I have color variant. And you can see that the color swatches are completely working fine. Now I told you in the starting of the video that in order to display variant images, you should have that selected on the product backend. Where you will need to select that? Let me show you. So let's go back to the dashboard. Click on products. And now I'm going to go to the same product where we have color swatches here. Click on t-shirt. And here you can see my variant images are selected. Now if I click on edit, you can add your variant image from here by clicking on add button here. So let me first remove it and show you guys how it's gonna look without it. So here you will have an option to select the variant image. Make sure it's selected to display variant images on your color swatch settings. Now after removing that, if I move back to my customize settings, go to that product, and I'm going to click on theme settings. We'll have to refresh to display the latest customized settings. And you can see we have color swatches showing up here. And now let me switch to variant image. You can see it's not displaying the variant image where we haven't selected that. Now let me select it on the product backend and see if it's showing up on the front end. For the green color, we'll be selecting green color. And then click on save. And now let's go back to customize settings and hit refresh. And now you can see that the variant image for green color is showing up completely fine. Cool, right? Now go back to swatch type. And here, in order to make sure you have the dual color swatch showing up completely fine, make sure the value is same as the product backend for your color swatch. So for example, I have this dual color swatch here where I have these, where I have added these hexa color codes for two colors, right? Make sure this option is spelled and capitalized same as the product backend. So if I go to my variants and check out this green red, which is responsible to display the dual color, you can see the label here is same as this one. Now, if I add any spacing or change the capitalization, it's not gonna work. See, I just added a space and now it's not showing my color swatches. So make sure you don't do this type of mistake and have the same label characters and capitalization mentioned on your theme settings in order to make it work properly. And the rest of the features I've already shown you guys. So if you want to change the swatch style to square, you can do that. Square round corners. And you can increase or decrease the swatch size. Cool, right? That's it for the tutorial, guys. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to implement that on your paid theme. Or if you have any feature recommendation for this tutorial, would love to have feedback from you guys in order to improve further. Until next video, have a great day.